This is Loka. One can understand that Krishna has spoken 700 shlokas. But this is the essence of Bhagavad Gita. Why he spoke so much? Because Arjun was he was worried. And in this shloka he said, Mahasu Chara, don't worry, don't worry. And we see in this material world, everybody is full of worry. We have nothing but worry. Only one gain in this material world is worry. So he talks about Jnana Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, and ultimately he talks about this Krishna Kanta Bhakti Yoga. And he is saying this is the summum bonum of the human life. If somebody can understand this, then he has got the perfection of life. And for that we need the Brajavasi spirit. Our Lakshman was in Vrindavan. Whenever we go to Vrindavan, I was with Dasarath Prabhu. So he has brought in Sirona is keeping and the sand from Jamuna. He has Giriraj Govardhan. Shila. So just to touch little blessings from them he is keeping. Prabhupada brought this Vrindavan, this Brajavasi spirit to the Western world. What is this Brajavasi spirit? That is the Krishna consciousness and the attachment to Krishna. See, there is one couplet in Hindi. Sesh Mahesh Ganesh Dinesh Suresahu Jahina Dhyana Na Paahe. Sesh means this, Anant Sesh. He has so many mouths. And he can always chant the glory of Krishna, but he cannot finish it. Mahesh is Lord Shiva, Devadidev. He is the Devanamatha Sambho. He is greatest among all the demigods. He also cannot fathom the glory of Krishna consciousness. Ganesh, the most intelligent demigod, is a demigod for buddhi, intelligence. He cannot find out the activities of Krishna, cannot understand. Suresh is the king of all the demigods, Indra. He doesn't understand. And Dinesh, this son, who knows everything, but he doesn't know anything about Krishna. Tahe hir ki chho hariya. That complicated Krishna, who is not understandable to those personalities, big personalities. Tahe hir ki chho hariya, damsels of Braj. The simple girls of the Yadu dynasty. Chachiya bar chha chhape naach na chhame. They just offer little chhach, buttermilk. Krishna says, oh Kana, come, come. You only take chhach? Yes. Stand here. We are just going to throw our cow dung and we will forget how many times we have to go. So you just wait to stand, when you become free, he will give you. And he will just stand like that, and these brush damsels, they will come, throw the cow dung one time, then just they tuck little part of the cow dung, put on his cheek, go second time, go third time, keep doing like that, and his full cheek will be full of cow dung. So simply, he's just standing. Why standing? Just for buttering. And who is Krishna, whose father Nanda Baba has lakhs of cows? His gosala is the biggest gosala. Bigger than our Prayag Narayan's gosala.
Jai Gomata. Can everybody say Jai Gomata?
Jai Gomata. So, but for not for this butter milk actually, he loves the gopis, he loves the Brajvasis. He is the heart, he is Samam Bolam. He is the complete existence of this Brajvasis. They are so attracted by Krishna. So that type of surrender. See, when Krishna goes to the forest and he plays the flute, and sometime in the mid of night he will play and flute. This gopi is, some gopi is serving mother-in-law, some is taking care of the child, some is taking care, serving prasadam to husband. So many different activities they are doing. As soon as they hear the transcendental vibration of this flute, they just run away. They leave home, they just go. Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? They just run. So, when they come, one gopi, she was locked in. Her husband says she is very, you know, she always goes run. So, he just locked. So, she left the body, went just by the soul. And took the transcendental form and reached there. So, when they appear there, they reach there, then Krishna says, "Hey, what? You are mad? You guys are coming in the night? You are supposed to serve your father-in-law, mother-in-law, your husband, your children. How can you just live like that?" And then they become completely sad. "What is this? You invite us and then you play like this." So that was his reciprocation. But one time, the Lord Krishna, he told, because the gopis, whenever they come to meet Sri Krishna, they always bring something to eat. So that is like Chappan Bhoga, everybody is bringing from their home something. So it becomes so many items. So one time Krishna says, "Oh, I don't want to eat anything." So they say, "What? We have prepared with so much love and devotion. What are you doing?" He says, "Okay, no problem. You go across the Jamuna. After there in Mathura, if you go to Mathura, Vrindavan, across the Jamuna there is ashram, Durvasaris. He says, "You go there and give to my Guruji this food." And he said, "What are you talking? This is a black night, so dark. And Jamuna river is just coming up more and more water. How can we cross the Jamuna?" "Yeah, no problem, you just go. Go on the bank, I give you one mantra, you just chant this mantra. Jamuna will go down." So he says that you tell Mother Jamuna, if our Krishna is complete celibate, he is a Bal Brahmachari, then you just go down. So they went and they told Jamuna, went down. And then they cross and then they go to Durvasa. Durvasa was chanting, "What is this? Why did you come? I didn't call any of you. Why did you come here?" "No, no, we have brought because our master Krishna has told to bring this thing for you." "So this is his desire. He wants that I should eat. This is his desire." They say, "Yes, yes, he wants that you should eat." "Okay, for him I eat." So he ate all the, whatever they brought, is give, all just taking, eating, everything, finish everything. "So okay, go now." "But how can we go? While coming we had one mantra. Now how can we return?" He said, "Give another mantra to you." So he said, "Go and tell that our Durvasa Rishi, if he doesn't eat anything except Durva, grass, then you please Jamuna go down." So they went. They told this mantra to Jamuna river. Jamuna went down and they crossed the river. And then Krishna was waiting. "Oh, welcome, welcome. Good. You are fit, our Swamiji." "But it is very surprising, very astonished. We are. What happened?" He said, "As far as you are concerned, we know. You are Atmaram, you are Rasraj, you don't need from anybody anything. So your mantra is perfectly alright because we know who are you. But what about this Durvasa? He was just eating everything he has eaten and She gave the fast mantra that go, if he doesn't eat anything, then you cross the river, Jamuna. What did he say when you went? Then he said that this is his desire, Krishna wants, so I should eat for him. So he said, you don't understand what he means. Did he ever call you? Did he come to your home sometime? No, never. He never asked anything. So he said, he does not require anything. He is full, completely with this durva grass. But just because of my love, just to satisfy me, see, now you can see my belly, it is full. He ate for me. That's the devotee. Devotee do everything for Krishna. These gopis do everything for Krishna. This Brajvasi, they do everything for Krishna. For them, there is no their life. Their life is completely, they are living every breath for Krishna. They churn the butter for Krishna. Actually, they just play this. They pray to their deities if Krishna can come to their home and steal their butter. But in the morning they will come to Mother Yashoda's house and they will just complain. You see, you have so much milk. What is the use? Your son is a thief. He is coming to our home. He is stealing the butter. And he also, not only is he stealing, eating, he is destroying, he is giving to all the monkeys and crows. He doesn't care for the things. So, Mother Yashoda will, you know, he will just put his head every day. What, my son, Kanhaiya, what are you doing? Why you go? She said, no, Mama. They are always telling lies. I never go. So, one day, one gopi was trying very hard. She said, okay. So she put a ghanti, this bell near this makkara. So when Krishna came there, then he said, Ghanti, don't ring, you know. I said, okay. So Krishna is just taking all the butter, he's giving to monkeys, he's distributing to all his friends. But later on, as soon as he eat, then the bell started ringing. He said, what are you doing? He said, this is your instruction in sastras. When anything is offered to you, Bhog will be not complete unless the bell is ringing. So we are ringing just for your pleasure. What is this? And then that mother of that, his friend. And his brother, his friend was also the part of this theft, whose house was this. That boy was also there. So his mother came and said, oh, now we got. She just caught hold of Krishna and said, okay, now go. I have to take him. Say, Kaki, leave me alone, please, Kaki. I will never come again, please, Kaki. So Kaki said, no. She is just making the wheel on her face and just walking very fast, going to Nand Bhavan to complain. So his friend, whose mother was going to take him complain, so he was also running. He said, my brother, give your hand. Say, Kaki, this hand is paining too much. Now you can't hold up this hand. So he took the hand of her son and given her hand. She has wheels, so she can, she's not seeing. She's just walking. And Krishna runs back and he went in Nand Bhavan and he's just doing like this. Ma, Yashoda, please, Maya, give me makkhan. And she is shouting from the gate, Nandrani, you always tell, my son is Narthi. Now we have caught, just see, when she brought. So Yashoda is putting, he's just saying like this, what happened you, Ben, sister, you gone mad? You even to your son, you are thinking he is my Krishna? Okay, good, at least you like so much Krishna. So he saw, oh, she is seeing, this is my son. So she became very sad. She just ran back, and while she is going back, in the street, Krishna appeared there. He said, Kaki, now don't do this again. If you play to me like this, I will just take farm out for husband. Okay, so don't do this.